Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. And today in this video I'm going to teach you how to make this beautiful neckline design. To make the neckline design, you can go ahead with a cotton fabric or else you can take a chandri cotton. And you need a two contrasting color embroidered thread and some white beads. So let's get into the video. And before making this video, I'm going to show you how to mark the neckline. So it's going to be a same like you mark your neckline, but this neckline is going to be little bit wide and the depth is not going to be the same. Usually I used to keep a depth like 8 inches from the top, but for today's project I'm going to take like 7 inches. So if you're trying to make a U neckline and if you feel that the U neckline is always low, make sure that you widen the neckline and reduce the height of the neckline. Okay, so now I am just widening the neckline and I'm reducing the neckline height to be 1 inch. Like if it'd been 8 inch, you have to take like 7 inch. That's more than enough. And now I have finished drawing my neckline and armhole and giving the allowance. Now with the help of your tracing wheel, you're going to trace the U so that you will get the same impression on the back side of the fabric. And then I'm going to put this fabric on the frame and then I'm going to work on that. And now we can see you're going to draw the same like this. And for sure I'll be showing you how to stretch this neckline. See, this is the center point. From the center point I'm going to keep some dots, and in the place of dots I'm going to give embroidery flower. So here comes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dots. So in center of the 5 dots, again you're going to have some dots like this. Again to the center you're going to have another dot. So 3 layers of center dots are coming. And from the center point you're going to have 5 points like this. This is the petal. So before making the petal, make sure you mark the dots like this. Believe me, it just came out really nice and it's a very, very beautiful design to make. And see, I'm just making a 5 dots like this. And now the single stand embroidery thread of Anchor Company. And you can see now I'm using a big needle, and if you ask me the number, sorry, I really don't know what is the number of the needle. And from the center you're going to pick up a little fabric and make sure you put the thread underneath and you make a lazy dicey stretch like this and lock the stretch on top. Very simple and very, very easy to make. If you have the stand, the job would be really simple. And don't worry, if you want to buy a hari stand like this, make sure you check with the Amazon link below. I have shared the link for my friends so that they can also try the all kind of patterns that I show in this video. And see, same like this, pick some fabric and put the thread underneath the needle like such and pull out the thread and lock the stretch like this. So this stretch is called as a lazy daisy stretch, and you're going to do the same to the entire points that I marked, the 3 layers of points. Okay, so you can try this on kurti, kurta and a kid's dress also. It's a very decorative design and for sure you will love it. And make sure you use a contrasting color thread to make the design even better. Okay, now I'm going to pierce it down. So it's going to be a continuous stretch anyhow. If you're going to add a lining underneath, the thread is not going to be visible. And you can see the same like that, I'm going to do this multiple flowers like this. Okay, so from here you can go ahead to the next side also. You know, want to go down and up. From here you can see I'm just getting into the center point. Again from there I'm getting into the next side. So same like this, I'm going to finish out the entire flowers in the dress. Okay, so So now once after finishing the flowers and to the center of the flower, I'm going to add a very tiny white color beads. That's going to enhance the beauty of the flower like this. And this bead is going to come in between the flowers, center of the flowers, and it's going to come all the way down in a random way. And now I'm going to sew this on the center like this. You can see. So make sure it's going to be a tiny bead. So the more tiny it is, the more beautiful it would be. Okay. So in between the flowers, I'm going to sew some beads like this. Okay. And now we can see these are the designs of three layers of flower. And again, I'm going to sew the beads to the downside like this. So I'm going to sew it in a random way like such. You can see I have already marked the place where I'm going to sew the beads. So three layers of flower and continued by the beads. You can see this is the end result. And this is how it's going to look once it's done. And hope you like this video. And if you like this video and if you want more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also don't forget to hit on the thumbs up button below. See you next time. Till then, take care. Bye bye.